You are watching Skyrim commentary from Shauna Films.
Okay, where are we now? Oh, this is, whatchamacallit? Dustman's Cairn. We have to get a piece of Wuthrad. So I've gotten pretty much most of my mods installed at this point. And I don't have a torch, so I can't see anything. Nobody can see anything. We're all blind, pretty much, in the dark. What's her name? Mickey's using high res fire?
You don't scare me.
And I don't remember where that high res fire comes from. I've been trying to be careful keeping with vanilla textures. Got vanilla, you know, flames, vanilla frost, and vanilla rain, you know, vanilla lightning.
What? Hey, that felt good.
But for whatever reason, one of the mods that I install decides to make all the fire high res. Maybe it's the one that leaves the decals on the walls, the impact, deadly, what's it called? Deadly impacts? It leaves fire marks, frost marks, and electrical marks on the walls, that decal mod. I think maybe that one changes how fire looks in the game. Anyway, so since then I've installed high def stuff. High def rain, high def electric, what is it? It's called electricity, I think that's what the mod's called. High def steam, high def dust and dirt and cobwebs, you know, all that kind of stuff. And I'll probably get rid of wet and cold.
What are you doing that for?
It's a bit too script heavy. I want to figure out why Feralda refuses to stand outside the College of Winterhold so I can take her test.
Fascinating.
Because I don't have anything controlling her. And yet, she's nowhere to be seen when I go to Winterhold. So I don't know what mod I installed that sends her back into her bedroom. She sits in her bedroom and never comes out.
Quiet.
The only thing I have installed that touches her is relationship dialogue overhaul. And that mod is it's all papyrus scripts, so I don't know how. I don't even know where to look in that mod for what's sending her back to her dorm instead of leaving her outside by the gate, at the entrance to the bridge crossing.
I shouldn't have pushed so hard.
Oh, she hasn't said that before, as far as I can remember. If she does say that, she only says it once.
We need to get back to your Vasker. All right, then. I want you to make sure you're honorable. If you are honorable and strong, then I can call you brother. Ysgrimor was the hero who started the Companions. Wuthrad was his weapon. He came from the ancient homeland and killed all the elves. But not all of them, because some of them are still here. Mm-hmm.
So the hair in the game is still vanilla. I haven't changed it yet.
Bad people who don't like werewolves.
The hair still has a shine to it.
All right, then.
And it's very low-res hair. It's not high-def. So it looks more like straw than hair.
What's going on? You make lovely pills. Talos wills
it. It looks like some guys are fighting each other here. This is a OBIS. For some reason, I thought OBIS was something else. I've had this sitting on my hard drive forever. I used it one time. I didn't really like it.
I heard about what happened.
It just wasn't working with the mods I had installed, and I didn't know how to edit mods back then. So I thought I would give OBIS another try. And I've patched the hell out of it so it works with 15 other mods I have installed, and I actually like this OBIS. I didn't understand the culture behind it. I thought everyone in a group would have the same shield, but that's not the case. Some people in some groups might have a shield, and they'll only have a shield for the gang that they're trying to join. If that makes sense. So you might come across like 8 bandits. Maybe 5 of them have shields, and each shield is different. So they're not organized. I don't know why it's called organized bandits. They're not organized. They're just random chaotic bandits. There's like 200 different bandits added to the game. And it's just, each one's picked at random. And each one has a random shield. So it's just weird to me. It should be called randomized bandits instead of organized bandits.
You look so pale. Are you ill?
I'm on a pilgrimage to the Shrine of Azura, the Goddess of Twilight, if you'll excuse me.
Let's see, does he have the little scars in his face? Oh, come on. Oh, I just messed up myself. You can't move when you're out of body. So now I'm stuck. Well, I can't move, but at least I have a camera that moves. Maybe I can at least look at his face if I can.
There was a companion called Parkas the Brave. He knew how to fight, but forgot how to shave.
Watch yourself.
Oh, sorry. I didn't mean to upset you. But you see, I've always found that song so adorable, and you must admit that it's quite funny too.
I am not adorable. It was not funny.
All right. I promise I won't do it again.
I don't believe it.
Well, I would try not to sing it again.
I hope so. Good lass.
Okay. Where was... Oh, yeah, I was trying to fix my camera. Every time I try to move, the camera comes out of my head.
I'm so glad that we're traveling to Elderglin Sanctuary together. The Skyrim wilderness is so...
So whatever buttons I push to disconnect the camera from my body, I have to reverse that. I mean, hit the same buttons, but just in reverse.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now I'm running around. Where's that guy? I just wanted to look at his face to see if he has the scars from another mod. The Dark Elves have little scars on their faces, and it's just... Each one has their own little weird scarred pattern on their face. It's not like a universal thing. Oh, let's see. Oh yeah, he's got something on his forehead there. Oh yeah.
Isn't it hilarious that milk drinker is an insult in Skyrim? But people...
Oh, I just noticed he's wearing the black robe that's hooded. I gotta make a mental note of that. Someone else wears a black hooded robe in my game. I just saw them last night. Oh, it's, well, this could be a random item in the game, but... Thalion? Is that his name? The guy in Morthal? I saw him wearing a black robe. Hooded.
If there's anything I can do for you, sure.
So maybe he picks a random outfit, like either the blue one to wear, or a black one to wear. I thought he always wears the blue one. Oh, but that was before I ripped out common clothing. I had to rip out common clothing because I had a bunch of naked old dudes in my game. Like, where are these naked old dudes coming from? It was nasty. And apparently, the version of Mothers and Daughters that I reinstalled comes with old dudes. Which I had forgotten.
You know,
why a mod called Mothers and Daughters has a bunch of old dudes with wrinkly old skin included is beyond me. That's beyond the pale. Why don't they call it Sons and Fathers? No, instead of Mothers and Daughters, it would be called Fathers and Sons? Is that how it goes? Why is it just sons? Why isn't it like fathers and sonthers? Yeah, fathers and sonthers. No, it's because of the Nords. You got some dude called Eric, right?
Here, you will often find butterflies.
Some dude called Eric has a kid, and he calls his kid Erickson. You got Davidson, Johnson, you know, that kind of nonsense. They didn't do that with girls, I guess. There's no mom. A mom called Mary and... No, instead of daughters, they should have a different name for girls. Son... Yeah, sons for the boys, and then for the girls you would have duns. Sons and duns. So you have Mary, and then you have Mary... You have Mary Dunn? Betty Dunn?
Need something? Suppose so.
June Dunn?
Got one all set. You've got a deal.
It's April, the one with the saddle. April Dunn. Oh, do they name boys after months?
Mm-hmm.
Or days of the week? Like his girl Friday. You know, girls can be named after any month, right? Pretty much. Do they do that? Do boys get named? I don't know any boys named October. Oh, come on. Vilya, get on yours. Now I'm just going off the tracks. I spent all day at work dealing with the general population, and that gets on my nerves.
You're writing me a song? Does it somehow involve-
so I probably should have de-stressed first before doing a video, but what can you do?
A ballad? Oh, now I know you're joking with me.
It's all true, I swear it. You can hear it when it's done. I'll just need a year or two.
So in my
I thought as much.
Oh,
think you might be in the wrong place, friend.
I thought we fixed this guy.
Of course.
Don't move, don't move. I don't want to see your delicates. Oh,
excellent. I think you'll be glad that you made this decision.
I'm very glad, actually.
Thank you. I'll be sure to put it to good use.
Hey, he's as pale as me. I don't know I did to this install, but all the Nords are pasty white.
Arcadia seems to know a lot about alchemy. Maybe she
now, technically, them. Nords are supposed to be pasty white, and they haven't been forever in my Skyrim. They've always been these tan, Tarzan-looking dudes. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of...
What is it now?
I like that the Nords are pasty white. Yeah, the Imperials have a slight tan to them, but the Nords are supposed to be white. I don't remember any of this footage. It seems like a month ago when I recorded this.
By the wood of the yard.
Really?
Right there.
I'm just waving a sword around. I'm gonna go to jail for that? You guys are harsh.
Smart man. Now come along with us. We'll take any stolen goods and you'll be free to go.
I don't have any... What do they call it? I don't have any reputation in Skyrim. And I don't have any persuasive skills or any speechcraft of any kind. So any lollygagging I do, I go directly to jail. No questions asked. If I'm loitering or trespassing, I get sent
Strange.
Right off to prison. Which is kind of cool. Which is how it should be.
My boys will keep you safe. Don't you worry.
I like that the default now in my game is everyone hates you. Go now, go away, as they all say to me. Go away. You want something from me? I mean, when they say you want something from me. Oh, speaking of white Nords, here's one right here. Get a suntan. Oh, two white Nords. I guess there's this, what do they call that? A skin tint? Color tint? Skin tint? It's color tint. That's what it's called. Color tint. RGB value. You just punch it in and hope for the best. And that gives your NPC the skin color they're supposed to be. And I don't know if it works according to the editor. I think if you just type in random RGB numbers, you'll end up with a head that doesn't match the rest of the body. I'm guessing. I don't think you can just go in the editor and change those numbers and expect a miracle. I think you have to do more than just that to change your actual DNA pigmentation and stuff. Now, the reason why John Battleborn was naked was because... I was trying out different sex lab mods. And then looking in the papyrus log to see how heavy the scripts were. If it was spamming the hell out of my game or not, if there was a naked man in the room.
Did you know that candle on the mantle hasn't gone out in over 100 years? Depends. Are you thirsty? Hungry?
You know, the
both.
Best
but the script just ran fine. It didn't spam anything. It didn't clog the CPU or nothing. But it wasn't working. The script wasn't doing anything. you know, it was like counting body bags, but it wasn't collecting the bodies, that kind of thing. So it was kind of like half working.
What can I do for you?
Because at this point I had...
You might be in the wrong place.
Wet and Cold was installed, and Wet and Cold was interfering with a whole lot of other mods. Wet and Cold is like throwing a wet towel in the game. It works, it's really cool, but it throws a wet towel on a bunch of other mods you might have in the game. And Hypothermia does that also. It's just a wet tile. Towel. So yeah, in my next playthrough, I'm going to be using Hypothermia 1.5 and 1.71.
Hi there.
The plus patch for it.
Have you ever had a sensible conversation with someone in this place?
Because I feel like experiencing Nord cold.
As a
dark elf, I want to experience the Nord cold weather. Oh. It's kind of pointless to run Hypothermia if you're a Nord.
Need something.
Because most Nords are supposed to be immune to the cold weather.
Come, I haven't got all day.
Oh!
This here's Candlehearth Hall. Great rooms upstairs, yeah. And there's a bed for rent on the ground floor. Sure thing.
I just squeeze between some stools to...
I'll show you to your room, right this way.
Gotta reach her so I can talk to her.
Bleh.
Yes?
And then there was,
Good idea.
I don't remember if I commented on this before, but there's this mod called... Blood on the Ice Redux.
Okay.
I'll and here. It didn't work. It wasn't working for me. Well, it turns out it doesn't work with Immersive Citizen AI Overhaul.
Ain't nothing up
here. AKA the bed mod. I call it the bed mod because it adds beds to Skyrim. Actually, that Immersive Citizen AI Overhaul should be called Beds of Skyrim. Because that's technically what the mod is, Beds of Skyrim. Everyone in the game now has a place to sleep. It's kind of a neat mod. It adds dialogue, but to tell you the truth, I got burned out on it. Because it adds dialogue to the game, but it repeats that same dialogue over and over and over. How many times can you hear Nazim talking about how ripe or not some vegetables are?
Must you bother me now?
After you.
You know, and so for years I've had Immersive Citizen AI Overhaul and RDO install, and the two don't always win their battles with each other. Something happens and dialogues get messed up. So I thought, you know what? Yeah, see, that's her bed, that's her bed. Who else has a bed? Too many beds in this place. He's got a bed.
Yes? All right, then.
Has Elda told you the story about her?
Oh, I had a brain fart. What was I talking about?
Lost?
Not maybe you should ask about it.
So RDO, I ripped that one out, put it back in to make sure all of its records and files are default setting. And sure enough, RDO has my NPCs saying things I have not ever heard yet in my game. So that's like a whole reason to play another playthrough of Skyrim, because everyone's talking differently to me now, for the first time in like a long time.
It's so nice to just talk a little, you and I. I was just thinking, as I told you before, it was not ever since I'm therefore what I of course.
So I think when Immersive Citizen AI Overhaul was installed...
Oh, I actually have a pretty good idea about that. And I'd be happy to tell you all about it. But not right now.
Yeah,
we have things to do, haven't we?
RDO didn't get a chance to shine in the spotlight because Immersive Citizen AI Overhaul
was dampening it. I could understand that.
It was muting some of the stuff RDO wanted to say in the game.
I can understand that you need some time for your own thoughts instead of listening to me all the time.
And plus, I've got Skyrim Reputation installed. So that adds even more different dialogues to the game.
Let's hear it. You've taken up enough of my time.
Like what she said right there. Speak with you. That's from Skyrim Reputation.
Always a pleasure.
And then she scripted to say her lines. She's not gonna talk different to me. And I need some gold, I'm guessing. Anyone see me? I want to take some food. This is a cool maneuver she's doing. I don't have that kind of agility yet.
Please, won't you buy a flower?
So these people sitting on the carpet, warming up in front of the fire, they're all going to be gone when I remove Immersive Citizen AI Overhaul.
I'm so glad that we're traveling to Elderglen Sanctuary. Of course.
That kid's going to be sleeping outside in the snow, where she belongs.
I had a dream that there was a good dragon. He was old and gray, but he wasn't scared.
And then I'm not only talking about the weather. The people don't offer any warmth either.
That also means NPCs are not going to go indoors when it's raining. They're just going to stay outside when it's raining or snowing. So I won't have any more situations where everyone's piled up in a tavern during a blizzard. I mean, it's neat when that happens. But I don't know if I'm going to miss it.
Depends. Are you thirsty? Hungry? Both.
So in my last playthrough, I married this person. Using console commands. And I thought... Blood on the Ice Redux... Mm-hmm. Keeps her alive.
Thanks for wasting my time.
And the other girl alive. But it only keeps her
Thanks
alive.
Thanks for wasting my time.
Because I didn't know if I had the mod installed correctly. I was under the impression it saves everyone from dying during that quest. But it only saves Susanna.